Well, as you can see, I come back from fishing. Oh yes, I'm back from fishing. It's hot. Gonna be doing lots of watering, but the peas are doing good. I've been picking. So I'm gonna go and do some shelling. You gonna do some shelling? Hey, you gonna help? Hey. Yeah. These ones, got most of these picked. Look pretty good. Yeah, them ones. Missed them too. Carrots are looking really good. They're not too thick. They come up nice, so. Let's get at it. That'll make a couple of Ziploc bags full. Another 3 or 4 days. We back out picking again, so they're coming on pretty quick. These peas don't get overly big. The skin is very thin, but the peas are really nice inside. And most of them are really long. Yep, get them shelled, get them bagged in the freezer. Morning. I'm going to show you something a little different today. Little DIY. I'm a smoker, so I do things a little different than most people. You can have a look and just if you have any questions. Going to be a little noisy here at this machine, but if you have any questions later, shoot me a message and I'll try and answer the question. But this is what I do. Helps me save some money. That is, I'm going to show you what this is all about. If you don't understand by seeing what we're doing here, I didn't video. I took some stems out of this, and now we're going to show you what happens. I have a tub down there underneath. I've separated the table, so I have a tub down underneath, so hopefully you'll be able to see what's going on. getting some supplies made for the next few months. I do this about every 6 months, and then I'm good to go. So save some money and show you what we got here in a little bit. Well, I just thought I'd make a short little video here, add a little in there, just a little DIY. We're not no sponsored by anybody, not advertising anything. Really, just this is a way that, you know, we do things to save a little money. We build our own stuff. We, you know, grow our own stuff. So, yeah, hope you enjoyed the video, and that's what we wound up with. So if you're like me, this is neat. I do this about every 6 months, and that's all I need to do. So we'll catch up with you a little later, and we're just trying to get some chores done. And follow me around the yard a little bit, do a little this, a little that, and get some building going on here. So we're gonna see a little of that. Hope you enjoyed our little trip fishing, whatnot. If you haven't seen my little road trip, just jump back a video or two, and there's a few there, some good fishing. So we'll just follow my life along. This is just stuff that I do every day. Catch you later. Bit of darker leaf. Got two different kinds here. I mix the two of them together. Just a little bit left to do, and we'll have her wrapped up. get that prepped. Get that prepped. I'm going to start on some tin today. House going to get a little facelift. Made them mad. I tore down their nest. Look at the lilies. The lilies are blooming. Lilies are coming on nice. Pansies are blooming. Yes, it's another day. Well, we got all our goodies kind of laid out. What we need. Got one starter edge up there on the roof. So I'm going to drag up some tin, and we're just going to speed you up a little bit. line up the next one. Hopefully the wind don't pick up anymore. It's kind of trying to. Most of our strong winds come from the northwest, so that little lip, I weren't going that way, but I have to start at this end of the roof. Right now I got two bees nests at that end. I got one over here that I killed off yesterday. The other ones still have live bees around them, so gotta get this side done, up to my solar panels or up to my chimney, work on that, and we'll show you a little more. That'll be still buzzing around here. But underneath. Yeah. Should be able to just line the top up. Line it up perfect with the other one. And I got the bottom spaced at half inch. I marked them before I brought them up. So just try and make it a little easier, see where I am so I'm somewhat square. Well, now, straddle the ridge and don't slide off.